Yeah, so, anyway, last year, John Broughton made an updated design for the portable 10-inch telescope, and I'll show just a couple of slides on that. And we went to Australia to pick up that telescope and then go to Papua New Guinea for the event I'll talk about next. But this shows the old design. I'll kind of just let you read through it rather than me talking. Okay, go to the next slide. This shows the new design back in Maryland. The two halves of the two suitcases. Now you can read again. Okay, next. It shows all the components based on our deck. There are two PC 164 CEX2 cameras. At least one of those could be replaced by run cams or night eagles. You can see the one that's used for the telescope in the upper and the one that's used for the Mighty Mini in the lower. Next. Mighty Mini is used as a finder. So this shows the, just again let me read. Okay, the this shows both fine pointing controls from the back here of the telescope. The bottom one is the altitude adjustment screw, and the one on the left is the azimuth, essentially the azimuth, but it's really orthogonal attitude. Just let me read there. And this just shows detail of the left-right mechanism. Shows how there's a knob there that moves left and right then. And the bottom view shows the altitude adjustment screw. This is the total weight is within the airline limits. Theoretically, that does fit in the suitcase, but it's rather tight. We preferred to put the two halves in two suitcases, and then it was easier with all the other stuff we had to take. The new design is pretty similar, but we've replaced the bottom of a single piece rather than the two-piece situation before, and setting up so it's sets up like a tripod with 3 feet at the bottom there. And there are a few other changes. On your side showing the two control screws. And the legs attached. You see it's a little more compact than the other design. And it looks pretty similar, but there's very steady motions in both directions. And this is just a picture showing again the components. Okay, so I'll just let you read through this. This was essentially John Broughton's message. Somehow the slides are cutting off a bit. I wonder if you could, can you show the PDF version of the presentation? Okay. Okay, I'll try to modify it. There's not too much at the bottom there. He hasn't installed the D-Vellum yet, as he says here. He still has to add a mount for the video finder and the D-Shield. So the D-Shield is a 3/4 side vellum that wraps around the 10-inch box. That's the reason those struts stick out in what you saw in the picture. And he says he plans to make 3 more for his own use by next April and then retire the old versions, the ones he has. So he's wondering whether there might be enough interest to build many of these for the occultation community. If we could get 100 pre-orders, maybe someone would be willing to manufacture them. This isn't just a single purpose design. It could be used as a visual telescope for some answers in the text. In addition to motor drives and stepper motors and alternative focus could be added quickly. Yes, it's a 10-inch, I believe it's 10-inch. I don't know if John has some 12-inch ones too, so confirmed it's 10-inch. So he said, I'd be interested in getting a spare of these to show at the NEAF meeting next year. It's in April in the same time frame. So that would be useful. Last April, I talked to the people at Skywatcher, and we bought one of the scopes while we were there because we wanted to duplicate the SWIRI system. The large aperture, but complained to the technical guy that here you have all this structure in the front to hold this Newtonian design, that instead of the prime focus design that John Broughton has, John would make it a visual telescope that has to have a Newtonian angle, but I told him, if you didn't have all this structure to support the secondary and all this, you just had a strut holding a camera, you wouldn't need all this extra weight and all this extra stuff, and you could make a much more compact design. And when I brought him over, I showed him this 10-inch scope to show him, and he said, it's kind of an interesting design, but they weren't interested in trying to build it. He said, if you want, we can supply the mirrors for it. you'll need to find someone else. But we should think about this before April to see if there might be some serious interest in building such scopes. I was thinking that the Northern Virginia Astronomy Club here locally is very active, has over 1,000 members, and they're also doing all sorts of interesting telescope designs and everything. And I showed them the earlier version of the suitcase telescope at the Astronomical League Convention that they held, and some of them are quite interested in that. So I think if we can maybe get, think of some other applications this could be used for, and if I could talk to that group, we might be able to get some interest in how this might be manufactured here in the U.S. Well, it's, yeah, it's certainly the town interest is much better. It's, you know, 10 times the light gathering power than the maxi. I definitely prefer to use them. And they're easier to set up the maxi at some points. The video finder, I got quite adept at using that and pre-planning them. And even though it's a smaller field of view. That's all I have for now.